21st. Our assignment is to present to you as you request your participation. People that I refer to as the people of the moment. Your Excellency knows too well that we went to our participants without any assurance.
And yesterday, you order that this to be my day, you want to make it. where you live. Because you are thinking far ahead. Thank you for calling all of them together. Well, Mr. Chairman, I said everything. I'm very grateful to all of you that have come. You are almost 99% present here. It is wonderful. And the report we have tells us that you are wonderful people because you are always thinking about the success of the party in the next election. And we have already the question for music. And there is no manner. And these are suitable things. By the special grace of God, the governor is going to have another session with the ESCO in this evening, and it will be a great opportunity for us to present the executive summary of the report that we have received from all of you, from the committee that we send, and most of you serve in these committees. Thank you for coming, and please wait and hear from our governor, and God bless all of you. Thank you.
Interaction and persuasion. the situation, the overall interest of the party. And that has also been going on. Two things I would like to say here. Firstly, to thank all the party leaders who have been part of this process of building consensus. And most importantly, I also want to thank you all, the SA who have already been part of this. Thanking you for the cooperation that you have honored the elder leaders, party leaders that spoke with you, engaged you, and sometimes told you things that you didn't want to hear, and so on and so forth up until now. But today, I thought, even before receiving the formal report, I didn't even know there was a suggestion that I should meet with you all. I always know that I'm going to meet with you, and I mentioned it to the party chair and the Sapuru. Because my ground upon the subject of meetings, meeting with people, discussing with people, engaging with people, it doesn't mean you always agree, but at least they engage by offer. And most times it solves a lot of political problems. Even smaller parties, like the other party, I don't like to call that party name in this state, because even the name is offensive, isn't it? As a party that doesn't know our place, that doesn't have anything good for our people, well, can't be our party. Even that one, I hear somebody just went into one of them and sat down, well, we don't have a house in this state, up to now. When you go to a hotel room, sat down. And the goodness of everybody that is married and standing, they don't, therefore, according to the laws and the rules, have any family nominated candidates. They don't have any family. Did they go to any family? Well, we will hear more about that as the days go on. And as soon as that happens, I don't know. So the temptation was there. Yet you have shown resilience, you have shown loyalty. And this is why for now I'm moving forward, especially if you play it well, you are the most loyal member of the party that I know now. Because loyalty is not by passing an exam. And if you score 40, 50, they are passed. Maybe if you also up to 60, they give you a B. Or if you get 70, they give you an A. That's good. But in the case of loyalty, it has to be 100%. And when things are good and convenient, and people like their comfort zones, you dash them what they are dying to have, they will pretend to be loyal. There is no loyalty unless it has been tested and proven. That's why, as someone who has been involved in party organization, both at state, in opposition, nationally in opposition, and contested elections up until now, tough elections, and working with people, both from within and without, I know it did not do a lot of loyalty. So when I say you are the most loyal people in Benin and to our government, I truly mean it. Because there are a lot of people that I know on the other side. People who contested with you, who today say they are winners. Who, if they were in your shoes, they would not be there now. So we stand in part for ourselves. All of you. Now, that's why I said I'm a CEO. I'm thanking you for your loyalty. And I'm known for a few things. One of these is that I speak my mind. Don't know how to be doing this incredible thing. I appreciate sincerely your sacrifices and your loyalty. In any human event, no human event can be perfect. Are you saying anyone that is perfect? So, when you say there are no winners and the past itself is a winner, that's what you mean. Could have been anybody. But the important thing is if you are steadfast and you stay in the party and in the system, what comes around always goes around. I tell people a lot of this story because I have also been part of a long hour contesting elections, harmonized out, sometimes harmonized. So, my God, if you are steadfast and you are in the loop, the system, the day that it will come to you, you just get mad at the people that are saying, no, you have to have a successful person. That's the way this as a thing works. And the right thing is that the fact that if you are in the system, and you're in this game, there's nobody here that do not have ticket of our party at one time or the other, or the key positions in your party's government at one time or the other. All of you, some are very serious positions, but I believe that all of us here, including me, God is not here to have peculiar issues that I need to know, then as leader of our party and leader of our states, even for people who are not in our party, I have a subject, not to talk about my own party people. Anything affecting you affects me. I should be concerned. Should be concerned. Feel free to let me know what those peculiar issues and challenges are. But broadly speaking, moving forward, I want to let you all know the following decisions that I'm taking on concerning you. Firstly, all of you who were holding appointed positions in the government, who for one reason or the other did not make it this time, I hear and now direct to immediate return to service. And even those people who show good faith,
that's why
it, putting it goodly. Of all of us in this room, and the only person who cannot run the election again as all my mistakes. Not true. Many of us have had my constitutional limits. But any of you, all the rest, you never get there. What God has in store. Tomorrow, this, tomorrow, that, the politics set us. And I find this one. This is the fight for politics, for it pays to be like this. So, I would like to have that list. That list, I know the rest of young people and those who are coming to the positions. But there are a number of other people whose reports I got in terms of their capacity to mobilize the ground, in terms of support base, and I didn't follow up the reports that were given to me. That's why I said, as far as I'm concerned, you guys are more relevant than the people that were setting out. They can't win without two people. They can't.
Yes, sir.
They can't win without two people. Each one of them is going to rely on all of us, led by me. Which of them will go there to act so strong and so bold? A number of them may think so. Some may already have thinking so. That they are strong. They know how to. They don't know the game. They don't know the game. They can't go nowhere without our support. If you are in the games, a lot of writers, politicians don't calculate things well. If you are in the games, then you rely on the federal Supreme Federal Knights to contest election and fight us also. If you are in PDP here, you don't have any other force to rely on except the quality of the state and the system. So they don't know. They think they are strong, they think they know something, they think they are what happened, what happened. It's no other person that can give support to fight an election in this state. It's going to be this morning I was walking out of the competition. Strong together and move and win again, even after.